YouTube. This is my latest attempt to create fatty acids from simple compounds which may have been present on the early Earth. The demonstration of how fatty acids can be created by natural processes is critical to understanding how life might have originated on the primordial Earth, because the membrane of primitive cells most likely contained fatty acids. And so, of course, living cells cannot exist without a cell membrane to encapsulate the contents. I recently came across an excerpt from a book sold on Amazon where the author describes how fatty acids can be made from a mixture of methanol and methyl mercaptan, also known as methane thiol. In the book, they show the mechanism of how the sulfhydrogroup of methyl mercaptan reacts with methanol to form a carbon chain of increasing length, eventually leading to the formation of fatty acids. The link for the section of this book is in the description. Anyway, this was truly an experiment in the classic sense, since I didn't really know what was going to happen. I took an amino acid powder, which I had on hand, which contained only amino acids and no fillers or other ingredients. I added this to a solution of methanol and water. I then put this mixture in my hydrothermal reaction vessel and heated the mixture to around 300 Celsius at a pressure of 800 pounds per square inch. The reason for conducting this experiment using the amino acid mixture was that it contained the amino acids cysteine and methionine, both of which have sulfhydrogroups, just like methyl mercaptan does. I was hoping that the sulfhydrogroups of these two amino acids would react with the methanol in the same way that methyl mercaptan does, thereby producing a fatty acid chain by the same mechanism as methyl mercaptan. So, here you can see the results of this experiment under the microscope. I would say that the experimental solution, when compared with the control, has the same spherical structures, which in the control are fatty acid vesicles. Notice how the smaller spherical structures on the experimental slide are virtually identical to the smaller spheres on the control slide. I'm going to let this video run for a while so everyone can examine both of the experimental slides that I have compare the vesicles from the control and the experimental. And so any comments are welcome on this video, and thanks for watching.